jambo, jambo bwana, habari gani, nzuri sana. Wageni, mwakaribishwa, Kenya yetu, hakuna matata.
We're here in Nairobi, Kenya, as we commence Youth for Africa 2018. It's going to be our very first trip here to Nairobi, Kenya. Alhamdulillah, we just landed here and we're set for 2 weeks of activities with our team here, inshallah ta'ala. Alhamdulillah, we have 22 brothers and sisters coming from the U.S., youth who will spend one entire week each working, inshallah, all throughout this country.
There's a place in your heart, and I know that it is love. And this place could be much brighter than tomorrow. And if you really try, you'll find there's no need to cry. In this place, you'll feel there's no hurt or sorrow. There are ways to get there if you care enough for the living. Make a little space to make a better place. Heal the world, make it a better place for you and for me and the entire human race. There are people dying. If you care enough for the living, make a better place for you and for me. Yeah. You want to know why? There's a love that cannot lie. Love is strong, it only cares for joyful giving. If we try, we shall see. In this bliss we cannot feel. Fear or dread, we stop existing and start living. Then it feels that always love's in a.
We come from America, 300 million people, and you know what? We love you. We love you. Ask me why.
Why?
Because the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam says, La tadkhulu jannah hatta tu'minu. You will never go to Jannah until you believe. Wa la tu'minu hatta tuhabu. And you will never believe until you love one another. Do you love me?
Yes.
Do you love them?
Yes.
All of them?
Yes.
We love you too. Assalamu alaikum.
Growing, so make a better world. Make a better world. Heal the world. Make it a better place. For you and for me and the entire human race. There are people dying. If you care enough for the living, make a better place for you and for me. And the dream we were conceived in will reveal a joyful face. And the world we once believed in will shine again in grace. Then why do we keep strangling life while this earth crucifies its soul? Though it's plain to see, this world is heavenly.
One thing that really stood out to me is, despite the fact that these people have nothing, nothing compared to what we have in our lives, they are so grateful for Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala and the stuff that He's provided for them.
We could fly so high, let our spirits never die. In my heart, I feel you are all my brothers. Create a world with no fear. Together we'll cry happy tears. See the nations turn their swords into plowshares. We could really get there if you cared enough for the living. Make a little space to make a better place. Heal the world, make it a better place. For you and for me and the entire human race, there are...
The Water for Life program, I think it's a very essential program because a lot of people have said that they can't send their kids to school because of the fact that they have to go and fetch water for the families. So having these shallow wells nearby is very important because it helps the kids and the families have the water so they can focus more on school and their education.
If you care enough for the living, make a better place for you and for me. Heal the world, make it a better place for you and for me and the entire human race. There are people dying. If you care enough for the living, make a better place for you and for me. Heal the world, make it a better place for you and for me and the entire human race. There are people dying. If you care enough for the living, make a better place for you.
I'm very happy that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala has given me the opportunity to be here and to experience for myself, immerse into an environment such as this with wonderful people who sisters were from all over the states. And I'm just very thankful for the experience.
If you care enough for the living, make a better place for you and for me. If you care enough for the living, make a better place for you and for me.
Heal the world we live in, save it for our children.
One day, just one day, just today, unlike you brothers who've been here, one day my life has been altered. One day for a couple of hours, it will never be the same. I see a lot of things now what the Prophet said, sallallahu alaihi wasallam. I understand them now. First, what Muawiyah has said. He said, "La hakima illa du tajiba." There's no wisdom without experience.
We visited that village to distribute the food. That's when it hit me, and I sort of lost hope. I kind of felt like these people are in this perpetual cycle of starvation and hunger and I really felt sad for them.
I honestly did not think I would love this country this much. I legit do not want to go back. Like, I seriously at least need another week or two for me to want to go back. I don't know. That's probably the case with many other.
Save it for our children.